Oh, this was the scene for most of the weekend. Don't I know it? Heavy rain caused some street flooding and made it difficult for drivers to get around. This is video that WDSU shot at Southern Oaks Plantation in New Orleans East. The good news, the rain has finally moved out. Meteorologist Patrick Crawford joining us now with our exact cast. And I saw a lot of kids inside today going crazy as they couldn't go outside and play. My daughter was one of them.
A lot of adults, too.
And a lot of adults, right.
Couldn't get out there.
It's been raining for like almost 3 days,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, pretty much. We've been dealing with the rain all weekend long. It's finally moved out, but the rain chances aren't completely gone. Rachel, I'll talk more about that here in just a moment, though. First, though, let's take a look at our exact radar, show you what's going on right now. You can see the radar is very quiet. We like it when the radar looks like this, but it was much worse earlier today with some very heavy rain. Now, this is a look at some of the rainfall totals. I'm waiting for it to load up here on the computer. Now, this is over the past 48 hours. So for the weekend, this is the rainfall that we've seen. Notice where the significant rainfall was located, along the Alabama Gulf Coast, also into the Florida Panhandle. That's where they saw over a foot of rainfall. Now, for us, it was not that high, but it was definitely stronger out there for the early part of the day. We had some heavy showers and thunderstorms. We'll zoom in here. You can see this bullseye right there close to the Mandeville area, southern Tangipahoa Parish, southwestern St. Tammany Parish. This batch right here is about anywhere from 1 to 3 inches of rainfall overall, and pretty much that's what everybody saw for the weekend, at least 1 to 3 inches, with isolated areas anywhere from 3 to 5 inches. So it was significant rainfall that we were dealing with all weekend long. But look at this right here. When we're getting grays and whites on the rainfall total, that's when you're getting over a foot of rainfall. So this is near the Mobile area. Also, there's a look at Pensacola. You can see that bullseye right there, about to anywhere from 12 to 13 inches of rainfall. Now, the big weather story for us over the next couple days, we're going to be watching this cold front right here. That's off to our west and northwest. That'll be making its way closer to the area for the work week. Unfortunately, what does that mean for us? It means more showers and thunderstorms. So you can see Monday and Tuesday, not a huge shower and storm chance, but by Wednesday and Thursday, those storm chances do increase. Now, the one thing I am worried about, Rachel, we've had so much rainfall over the weekend. We were talking about it just a few minutes ago. The ground, very saturated. Therefore, it's not going to be able to hold much water. So if we do get any rain, flooding will be another big concern. So it's something we're going to have to keep a close eye on throughout the week.
It was nice to have that break tonight to give us a chance, you know, to have that water.